The Honourable Member for Minto.
Speaker, on Tuesday, the Minister of Finance told Manitobans that important capital projects for Manitobans are now under review.
That's right.
We've already heard this Minister responsible for Crown Services say that although he won't interfere with liquor and lotteries, he's already called up board members of the newly appointed board to tell them what to do.
Yep.
He's going to send them a letter telling them what to do, and he expects them to report back, and he'll tell them what to do. We know that other capital projects are now at risk with this new government. Could the Minister of Education advise whether the expansion of Tec Voc High School in the West End of Winnipeg will proceed as planned without delay?
There we go.
The Honourable Minister of Education and Training.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I'd like to thank the member for the question. As he referred to, we are always reviewing whether our investments are in the right place, the right time, and in particular for education. We are trying to get the best results for Manitobans from a well-invested dollar. So we are certainly reviewing, and we will continue to do. That one in particular is in process.
The Honourable Member for Minto on a supplementary question.
Madam Speaker, the expansion of Tec Voc was announced last year, and it's intended to provide a new wing for students in the welding program and the aviation and aerospace technology program. Tec Voc students come not just from the West End, but across the Winnipeg School Division, and they're in high demand by employers such as Standard Aero, Magellan, Boeing, and Air Canada. It is Aerospace Week in Manitoba, and these students represent the future of aerospace in Manitoba. Can the Minister of Education give a clear answer to whether this expansion will occur as planned, or whether Winnipeg students and families have to wait for this government to calculate an acceptable return on investment?
The Honourable Minister of Education and Training.
I thank the member for the question. After 17 years, perhaps you should learn to be patient, because you certainly have shown little results. This is Aerospace Week. There are many partners involved in that program, and we're in the process of building relationships with those same partners to make sure that any dollar that's invested on behalf of Manitobans is one that is well invested and that we get the best results. I certainly well aware that our aerospace industry is a significant contributor to Manitoba, and we want to invest wisely so that training in the aerospace can actually be positive in the process.
The Honourable Member for Minto on a final supplementary.
Well, I agree with the member that the aerospace industry is important. It's an industry that's important to my family and important to friends of mine. The member needs to understand that students at West End schools like Sergeant Park and General Wolfe and Isaac Brock are now making choices about which high school they're going to attend and what programs they're going to take. Right. The aerospace program at Tec Voc High School draws students from the West End and beyond, and the co-op and the apprenticeship programs, which the members opposite never talk about, are popular with students and also with employers in Manitoba. I'll ask the Minister of Education again, one more time, to give comfort to students, parents, and the aerospace industry in Manitoba. Will the expansion proceed as planned?
Yes. The Honourable Minister of Education and Training.
And I thank the member opposite. I would remind him that every student is reaching a point where they are making decisions regarding where they are going to go for their high school education. Every one of them, and so that I think it's important that we do a good job of making sure that the money is invested for the benefit of every Manitoban for maximum benefit. So we will work and have been working and will continue to work with the aerospace industry to make sure that money is well invested in training to get the best benefit for Manitoba. Yeah.